Hi everybody. Today I have been packing non-stop like a crazy woman because apparently my dear big sister called me and she can't wait to see me, and what turned out to be Tuesday's trip got bumped to Monday, and now Monday's trip got bumped to tomorrow, so I will be leaving tomorrow at 6 a.m. and headed up to see her. And I couldn't be happier. And yeah, I've been packing nonstop all day, and I'm not even done yet. And oh my god, I just got out the shower, and I said I have to make the video before it gets too late. And I don't think I'm gonna get much sleep tonight. So I'll probably open a bottle of wine in a little bit and just have a glass to unwind, and I hope I don't forget. God, I hope I don't forget anything. I've been packing. I got the essentials, I think. I mean, I have the important things. And I have the ED staples, which are my supplements. I'm taking a scale up there because my sister doesn't own a scale. Can you believe that? That is like shocking. That's like someone not having sliced bread in their house. It's just unnatural to me. And yeah, she doesn't have a scale, and I'm taking a scale up there for her. And she could keep that's my spare scale, because you know you have to have more than one, because you just can't trust the one, because the one lies to you. And you kind of want to jump on the other one that's friendlier. And so yeah, I'm gonna take her a scale, and I'm taking my supplements up there, and I don't know if I should take the shake up there. I think I will. I think I'm gonna do that. She has a blender. Yeah, I think she does. And if she doesn't, I may have to take my blender, and I have a bullet blender, and I don't know. I have to call her and ask her if she has a blender. But yeah, God, the things eating disordered people have to go through. What else? Yeah, today I've been binging and purging again. Yeah, and I had another attack with the sugar, and it couldn't have come at a worse time. I binged and purged one time in the morning. Well, it wasn't really morning, it was more like afternoon. It was afternoon already, and I was making dinner, and the dinner wasn't ready yet. Originally my plan was to binge and purge when my husband went to work, but he went in really late today, so, and I just couldn't anymore. So I went ahead and binged and purged one time. It was okay. And then the second time I binged and purged on dinner, and it didn't come all back up. And when I got out the bathroom, the sugar hit me, and whoa, it was really, really bad. And I had to make a very, very sweet milkshake or something and drink that. But I had to go back and finish, and I did, but thank God that the sugar didn't go back down, and I was okay. But yeah, the sugar is becoming a problem, and oh boy, I don't know. I don't like that this is happening. It scares me. I don't like to be shaking, and I don't like my sugar getting down, because it's so scary. And I'm gonna try my hardest to not binge and purge up there, because I'm scared. My sister and I have we have an odd sense of humor. Because we kind of tell it as it is. And also when we joke, we kind of joke, but in the sense of telling it like it is too. So she's been cracking jokes now that I'm ahead up there, that, you know, about the binging and the purging. And also she's kind of telling me like, oh, please don't die up here. And I don't, I mean, I know she's like joking, but I know she kind of means it too, and trust me, I don't want to die up there, and I hope that doesn't happen. So yeah, You have to be able to talk about that because you can't have an eating disorder and put your heart through so much and think that you won't die one day. And hopefully I will come back in one piece and I won't have a heart attack or anything up there. So I will try my best to stick to the shakes and not eat and just fast and drink water and God knows what else, and try not to strain my heart so much, and so I'm gonna try that. So yeah, I've just been packing like a mad woman all day today, and the binging and purging has taken a huge chunk of time, so everything is twice as long today. I managed to go to the post office and send out packages and things that I had to send out. What else? My daughter is super excited to go up there. I have to go in the bus, and that means a 4-hour drive. Well, actually 4.5, because the driver takes like a 15-minute break. You know, let's just say 5 hours, because the driver takes a break. A 15-minute break at a rest stop, and then another van comes and they switch, and then, you know, that's how it's done on the bus. And but also I estimate about 5 hours, because you know, people, they take their time, and some people are late, and some people are not at the stop at the time that they're supposed to be, or they have too much luggage, or they're kind of slow, and so it's gonna be a long one. And I am gonna be prepared. I'm going to sleep, and I'm going to take books. I'm going to take Unbearable Lightness, Portia de Rossi. I will read this, and I'm also going to take Evermore, and I'm going to read that. And I possibly am gonna take Wasted or Winter Girls. I'm not sure. Maybe. I don't know. I need plenty of things pro up there. It's my daughter's vacation, spring break obviously, and it's my vacation. And you would think that her kindergarten teacher would cut these kids some slack, but no. Witness this. It is homework. And look at this. It's like 20 pages. So now I have to do homework on my vacation. I don't want to do homework. I don't go to school anymore, and it's not fair. And now I have to do homework, and I have to do addition and mathematics and spelling, and I don't want to. So my poor daughter has to do homework, and I don't know how I'm gonna squeeze in homework and the vacation, but we'll see what happens. Maybe after breakfast, I catch her before the fun starts. But yeah, she's so excited, and I'm getting there. Maybe I'll get excited on the trip up there. Right now I'm just like trying to remember everything that I'm supposed to take, and yeah, I'm just a little bit nervous on the bus with all those people. I hope I don't have a panic attack. Maybe I should have a drink before I leave. I don't know. or smoke a cigarette or something. I haven't had a cigarette since New Year's Eve. And I don't know. Maybe I'll smoke on vacation. Or not smoke cigarettes at least. But yeah, it's a vacation. You're allowed to. And what else today? Yeah, tomorrow I guess I'll be vlogging from Orlando, and I'll be trying out the flip, and I hope it's easy to use and the picture is good. I don't know. And let's see what else. I'll try to post most of the videos on YouTube. I'll post what I can on Blogger, but you know, there'll be other things I'll put on YouTube, you know, like you know, just whatever kind of videos, maybe not ED related for once. And God, my husband thinks I'm leaving on Monday, and he's at work, and I've been trying to call him, and you know, he doesn't answer his phone at work, so he doesn't even know that I am leaving tomorrow morning. And oh, my poor kitties, I hope they're gonna be okay. I have to leave detailed instructions on how to care for the cats, because my husband has no idea. He's like, how many times do they eat a day, and how many times do they drink water, and all that stuff. And he's never had a pet before in his life, and doesn't know how to care for animals. And my kitties, they know something's up, because they're sleeping on my luggage, and they're sleeping on my boots that I'm gonna be wearing tomorrow, and they're sleeping on my bomber jacket, and so they know something's up. God, I hope they're gonna be okay. I hope I come home and they're still here, and one of them is missing, or missing a limb or something. And yeah, so that's about it pretty much today. It's been kind of hectic. I've been out, and then I've been here, and here it's just been chaotic and packing and purging, I'm afraid. And tomorrow, hopefully, I won't be too exhausted, and I'll see what I'm gonna do, because I have no idea, and I am just, my mind's going a mile a minute trying to figure out what to do. I didn't even get a chance to work out today. I missed the opportunity, and I guess I'm gonna just have to try to squeeze in a workout. I don't know, like a 5:30 a.m. workout or something. I won't get much sleep tonight, so I guess I'm gonna try to have to squeeze one in. Yeah, I have to. Okay, so that's it. That's all for today. I have more packing to do, and there hasn't. It's been a very boring, uneventful day, and I am getting my hair cut, possibly tomorrow. And right now it's I got out the shower. That's why it's so short and shiny. It's probably paler than usual. And yeah, I think I'm gonna cut it. Maybe. I don't know. I don't have much left. I mean, how low can you go? So, I will be seeing all of you again tomorrow. Different area code, different location, and hopefully better spirits, and hopefully a good day. And I won't be too tired or too drunk. So, bye to everybody. Happy Saturday to all, and I hope everyone's doing great, and wish me luck that I do not have panic attack on the bus, being around all the strangers, or that I don't end up with someone sitting next to me that won't shut up. So I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow, and good night. Bye.